In book 23 of the Iliad, Achilles and his army return to the Achaean camp. They mourn Patroclus, and Achilles vents his anger by abusing Hector's corpse. He vows he will not wash Hector's blood off his body until he has buried Patroclus. Later, Achilles falls asleep on the beach. Patroclus' spirit visits him in a dream, asking why he has forgotten him. His spirit cannot enter the land of the dead until his body has been burned. Patroclus asks that their bones be interred in the same jar when Achilles dies. Achilles reaches out to Patroclus, but he slips away like smoke. The next day, the Achaeans build a pyre for Patroclus. His body is surrounded with slain animals, enemies, and other goods. Achilles cuts a lock of hair he's been growing out and burns it with Patroclus. He vows that dogs will eat Hector's body. Aphrodite and Apollo keep it safe from animals and the elements. Achilles gathers the Achaeans for funeral games the following day. Diomedes, with Athena's help, wins the chariot race. Nestor's son, Antilochus, appeases Menelaus by giving up his second place prize. Odysseus and great Ajax tie in the wrestling match. Odysseus wins the foot race. Warriors compete in a boxing match, a duel, a shot put, and archery contests. Achilles awards Agamemnon first place for the spear throwing contest. Achilles takes his anger against Hector too far, abusing his body and killing captured enemies to burn with Patroclus' body. The appearance of Patroclus' ghost emphasizes the importance of a proper burial. Achilles is denying this of Hector, expressing a feeling of responsibility for Patroclus' death. Cutting the lock of hair he has been growing out symbolizes his choice to die with glory in war rather than return home. Achilles' rage seems to take a back seat to his role as host of the games. He is fair and diplomatic, graciously resolving a dispute about prizes that contains echoes of his own conflict with Agamemnon. These games were a way for fighters to win glory, honor, and prizes in peacetime, and they share many of the attributes of war. The games test many of the same skills used to make war without hurting the participants, and boasting plays a similar role in these contests as in battle.